Hey, you guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back. I'm not going anywhere. Peace. Peekaboo. I see you because I'm YouTube. What? Boost! Famous now. Available in 2021, the album. Probably not. Dad. AF. Call me mother. Rock on, gold dust. Boost! Woman! How are you guys doing today? Oh my god, it is a beautiful day in Indianapolis. I just kind of like lazed around in the house all day, and then I finally went outside to go get the mail. This is such my life, okay? I know people are like, oh, exciting life of a YouTuber. Yes, I like make coffee in the morning and I read my meditations, and then I kind of like, you know, wander out to the front yard by the time that I see my neighbors coming around, you know, in the yard and all that kind of, by the time. But I see my neighbors, I look out the window, I peek out the window. She's outside out there. I see my neighbors and they're all like walking out to their mailboxes. I'm like, oh, that means the mailman's been there. Now, sometimes when I'm out in my yard, I see my mailman out there. He's always real friendly and he waves to me and stuff like that. So anyway, I went out there and I got my mail. It wasn't anything exciting, but anyway, it never is. I miss the days of postcards and letters, don't you? I miss when people used to send postcards and letters and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, I got my mail and then I came back inside. I just filmed a Peterisms video. It was about fear versus courage. So I talked in there a lot about having had social anxiety for the majority of my life. So if you guys don't watch my Peterisms channel and you don't know what it is, my Peterisms channel is where I read meditation books. These two are from Melody Beatty. Y'all know these are my favorites. This is The Language of Letting Go. It's a sister book to Codependent No More. This is Journey to the Heart. These are my two favorite meditation books of life. But I've been reading this Cindy Spiegel book, which is called A Year of Positive Thinking. And it has just these little quotes in there. So today's was about courage versus fear. And I talked in there a lot about having had social anxiety for the majority of my life and being afraid to show up to things and what would people say. And my, you know, as a person in recovery, we talk about addiction being formed in 100 forms of fear. So that's kind of a little bit what the Peterisms channel is like. I haven't done a roll call of my channels in a while, so let's do it. So I got my Peterisms channel. I have this channel, which y'all know you love. Okay, you love it. Are you still subscribed? Did YouTube unsubscribe you to this channel? I'm sorry. YouTube unsubscribed me on my own channel. I mean, I don't know if they did, but they probably would. Anyway, and then I have my vlog channel, which people say is like a podcast. I just drive around all night long and I, well, not all night long, but for like an hour and a half, and I talk about stories of my life. Last night, I told all kinds of stories about the casino and my good GD Valerini at the casino. So anyway, because we were going to the casino last night, of which my good GD Valerini, she got 3 hand pays, okay? And that means that that's over $1,200. Peter Monn left with 0 last night, okay? And then I have my review channel of where I do like all kinds of reviews of Starbucks drinks, but I've been doing a lot of food over there lately. I've done the crumble cookies. I did the insomnia cookies. I did Taco Bell nacho fries. I've done all kinds of stuff. Then I have my Peter Does Stuff channel, which is where I just, it's so much fun. It's like OG, like YouTube over there. I'm just kind of doing random stuff. The other day I scratched lottery tickets and I won a lot. I won more than I've ever won on a lottery ticket before, live on camera. I couldn't believe it. And then my last channel, which was my first channel, is my BookTube channel. And, that's my heartstone. I love my BookTube channel because that's where I started. And, so anyway, this right now, currently, I am reading A Good Day for Chardonnay by Dorinda Jones, which is the second book in the Sunshine Vikram series. Oh my god, I love it. It's the book that started me on the cozy mystery whole deal. And then right before that, I finished my second Peter's book club pick for July, which was People We Meet on Vacation, and it was fantastic. It was like a rom-com. I was at the pool, and I was laying on my stomach trying to get my back and my legs tan, and I was sobbing, okay, at the end of this book. And I'm like, people probably think I'm, the three old ladies up here probably think I'm crazy. Anyway, they love me though, the old ladies at the pool. Let's get into this. Before I do, okay, I want to crack open a little bit of a Diet Coke here, but I want to show these cups, and I showed them before. This is not sponsored. They were just nice enough to send them to me because they know how much I love their products, and this is Swig brand. But the reason I want to talk about it again on here was because last time I didn't talk about my code. I just listed my code underneath there. So this is what happens. You put the Coke or whatever. They have tall, skinny ones for Trulies. And that's what my husband and my cousin and everybody uses them for. The Trulies and the White Claws and all that kind of stuff. Or you can put beer in there and whatever. And then it keeps your Coke or whatever cold for like 10 hours. No lie. Okay? And then I also got this coffee mug, which my husband said, why did you pick that one out? I don't know. It's just really cool. But I have to tell you, I couldn't figure out how to close it. And then what happens is when it's open, it's sealed. And when it's closed, and I just used this one yesterday. Then this is my new coffee cup for fall. I haven't used this one yet, but I love it. And then I gave one to my good Judy. And then here is my other one that we had before. But since I'm talking about it, I do have to show you this. My good Judy Tanya Jean, she just texted me this today. She's out on the boat and she texted me a picture of hers and she's using it. She's got a little water bottle in there. So anyway, my code is PeterMon15. I will link it below. You guys, I'm just doing this because I swear by it. It's not an affiliate code. I don't make any money off of it. I just want you guys to be able to have a discount because I love these cups so much. They're not super expensive. I think these are on sale right now for like $19.95. And they last for a really long time. We've had these for like a year. So, and they're still like in great shape. So, you know, I love them. If you watch my vlog, you know it's no BS because I use them a lot in my vlog. All right. Woo! After all that, should we get into the drama? Where's my lip gloss? Do I need a little bit of... When your lips are dry as mine, then it's what? Little beauty time! That did not sound great. Okay, so today we're going to talk about Jeffree Star and how his people are not happy with him, okay? You know, it's interesting because I had not, like, really, like, read a Jeffree Star Twitter thread in a while. Like, I hadn't really, like, gone through and, like, read the comments. And it's so interesting to me because the comments can kind of be categorized into several different things, right? There's, and I'm just being completely fair in going through this, okay? There's... Well, he hardly ever gets any hate on his threads anymore, and I think that's because he's blocked so many people. But first of all, there's the people that are constantly talking about or dropping their makeup looks, and they're wanting him to notice their makeup looks, and some of them are phenomenal and fantastic, and they're just so bad wanting to be on the PR list. And so they just constantly drop their looks, having used his products. Then there are people on there that are asking for him to cash app him money because they have some tragedy in their life. That would be the second group. Then there's the diehard stans that literally, you guys, have bought every product he has ever sold, and they post pictures of it. I was looking on there tonight. There was like 5 or 6 people that had pictures of like every mirror that they had, like he had ever put out. And I was thinking to myself, you know, like... I know that Jeffree Star doesn't feel like he owes his audience a whole lot as far as, like, answers. And I know that these people really don't care because they're just diehard fans of him anyway. But I thought, just for maybe the people that have literally spent $1,000 on mirrors, you know, maybe for them, you could maybe, I don't know, take a little bit of accountability for some of your actions, you know. But I know that they don't care anyway, so it's whatever. And then you have the other diehard fans that just completely kiss his ass and will excuse anything away from him. I mean, there are so many comments on there that are like, I don't really care what anybody says about you. I will love you till the ends of the earth. Okay. Now, I have to tell you, there's a fifth group, okay? And these are people that are a little disgruntled with what they got in their mystery boxes. There are people that are not happy. Peace. With their mystery boxes, okay? So first, before I get into this, I wanna give a little shout out to Tabitha because Tabitha was one of the first people that sent me this last night about people not being happy with their mystery boxes. So there you go, Tabitha. There's your little shout out, girl. Love you, love you, love you, love you. If you have any tear drama, feel free to send it to me. I get people that send me stuff all the time. But here's the thing is that a lot of times people send me drama about people and I'm like, I don't have any idea who this person is. They're like, could you please cover this story on YouTube? I'm like, I have no, I literally would have to go in and spend like a month doing research because I have no, and I'm not anybody's investigative researcher of the world. I'm just lonely. I'm a lonely doll. No, I'm not a lonely doll, not at all. But I don't know who a lot of these people are, so I have to do a lot of research. Okay, so let's go in here and talk about what happened. People started dropping complaints about the mystery boxes on Jeffree Star's Twitter feed. And the first picture that came up was where he showed this, apparently it's a yak. And he put this picture up here. I'm not going to put it up here, but it just says, "This gorgeous lady is Snowflake and she's due in November." And it was this picture of this yak or something like that. He's out on the farm. The interesting thing to me was how many people were wanting to know what Jeffree Star was going to do with her, okay? And they were like, "Are you selling the meat? Are you going to, like, turn it into fur? Because apparently yak hair makes really..." Like, they said something. It went on and on and on, okay, in the comment section. And people were serious. Like, they were really, really serious. And people were like, "Please do not, like, sell her for meat and all this kind of stuff." And I'm thinking to myself, Jeffree Star, okay, who his products are, you know, vegan, cruelty free, is taking a picture with a yak on his farm and saying that she's pregnant. Chances are he's probably not gonna sell her for meat. I'm just gonna say, okay? But as a vegetarian, I don't think that would be a very nice thing. But I don't think that's his plan. I think his plan is just to have a lot of really cool animals out there. I actually would love to live on a farm and have a yak. I would. I'd love to live on a farm and have all kinds of miniature animals. It is so funny. Because you guys remember, like, the little memes that came out, like, years ago? And it was the miniature giraffe that could, like, stand in somebody's... Okay, it's totally fake, right? But I have talked about this so much. We were at dinner a while ago. And somebody said something... This is actually a question on my video yesterday. Somebody said something to my husband about, well, like, would do you think Peter would ever live on a farm? And Alex goes, "Peter would love to live on a farm. He would love to have a farm of all just, like, miniature animals where he comes out. He's got, like, a little miniature, you know, Shetland pony and a little miniature pig and a miniature this." And he goes, and he's obsessed with those miniature giraffes. It's like, oh, my God. They're not real. I go, "Alex, they're not real. They're fake." But I wish they were. I so want to believe in the miniature giraffes, just like I so believed in sea monkeys back in the day. I did. I used to always have those sea monkeys when I was a kid. Do you guys know what sea monkeys are? Well, anyway, they're basically little brine shrimp, and I would have them in this kitchen, and I always had to, like, I had to save all of my things to mail in my $5, and then you get this big, like, plastic, you know, town, okay, of where the sea monkeys that look like little people, they really look like, what are they, all the Who's down in Whoville, they kind of look like Who's a little bit, you know, and they got these weird ears and stuff like that. And, but I really thought they were going to have families and drive cars and all kinds of stuff. I mean, I'm talking about up till about 10 years old, I did believe this. And it would start stinking so bad. And my mom would go, "Go pitch that down the toilet. It stinks so bad." She's like, "It's smelling up our whole kitchen." I'm like, "Mom, that's my city. I can't, okay? I'm in love with my sea monkeys." She's like, "There's not even one sea monkey alive in there." Sea monkeys were the biggest scam on the face of the earth besides the pet rock, of which I had one of those too. So anyway, people started coming for Jeffree Star underneath this picture, okay? And somebody said, "Jeffree, my supreme..." Jeffree. "Jeffree, now listen, Jeffree. We need to have a talk." And he's like, "Call me..." Okay, mother. Anyway, so she said, "Jeffree, my supreme mystery box arrived today. It only had 10 items. It was missing the Star Ranch palette and the magnetic palette for singles. I'm really bummed. I was super excited for the Star Ranch palette. I've seen a few people who have had the same issue." Somebody responded and said, "I only had 11 items, and they told me that told me to file a claim with the shipping agency that they did a quality check, basically calling me a liar." And somebody, this person responded and said, "WTF, clearly it's whoever packed our boxes at his shipping facility that's messed up. It's not the shipping company's fault or ours." First of all, if that is completely true, and I'm just going to go on the merit that this person that said it on there is true, can you imagine a company blaming it on shipping? Oh, wait a second. This isn't the first time that Jeffree Star has done this. He's done this in the past. Blame things on shipping companies, right? Not our fault. Not our fault that everything got broken in there. Oh, that must have been UPS's fault or whoever, right? Do you remember that from back in the day? This is not the first time that Jeffree Star Cosmetics has come out and blamed somebody else for the fault of their products. Kind of like the fault in our stars. So anyway, she said, "WTF, clearly it's whoever packed our boxes at his shipping facility that messed up. It's not the shipping company's fault or ours. This is so dumb. I emailed customer service today, so I'm still waiting for a response, but I expect I'll get a similar one to you and everyone else. And by the way, anybody that emails customer service and you get a response about these mystery boxes, if you are unhappy with them, please feel free to forward that information to me. I would be very interested in seeing that. And this person responds and says, don't hold your breath. Hopefully you actually get customer service. They are rude and don't know the first thing about customer service. So I thought that was interesting. Right underneath here is somebody dropping a look that it's a very nice look. From the Blood Money palette. So that's basically what his Twitter's right is always about. Now, if you go on, okay, on his other pictures since then, there's more comments about things. So this person comments, hold on a second, I need a sip of my Diet Coke. I haven't even taken a sip yet, have I? All right. This person says, I usually love and respect you and everything you do. I usually love and respect you and everything you do. Okay. Everything that Jeffree Star does, this person loves and respects. All right. I usually love and respect you and everything you... I mean, the people that love Jeffree Star, they would excuse away the worst things in the entire world. I mean, they really, really would. Okay? Like, this is the thing. People are always like, well, what do you want? What do you want? I want reality. Okay? I want reality. And I know that we need a lot of fantasy, okay, but fantasy is not excusing people away. And this is the problem with this, okay, is that you will hold one person to one standard, like say, oh, James Charles needs to be held accountable for such, right? Or Laura Lee, she needs to be held accountable for this. But when it comes to Jeffree Star, oh, no. Jeffree Star is held to a different, you know, standard. When it comes to this person, oh, he excuses away. When it comes to Shane Dawson, oh, no. It's just jokes. We don't, you know? And so the baseline of equality between these YouTube influencers is such crap, right? They're not held to the same standard. So anyway, but I digress. So this poor customer says, I usually love and respect you and everything you do, but you really cheated us with the deluxe mystery boxes. Unless the Z palette is valued at $34, which would be ridiculous, my box did not meet the $183 value. Extremely disappointed. And she put a little thing down here of what it contained, and it said the gloss for $18. Well, I can't add up because I'm on my phone. The VLL, $18. Lip balm, $18. Three single shadows, $30. Star Ranch, $28. Lip scrub, $12. Marble makeup bag, $25. And Z palette, not in there, okay? So anyway, interesting. Somebody else comments and says, what is this? In my mystery box, I'm so confused. And it's an empty palette for the shadows. And this person underneath here, it's like, you can see the picture. Hold on a second. I mean, it's just an empty box, okay? And this person responds and said, I think it's an empty palette for the shadow singles. Then somebody says, why did your company send me the same? Now, this is my hit thing with the mystery boxes. I have to tell you, I saw so many comments underneath there where people were like, this is my third such and such palette. Does anybody want to trade? Because I don't want these. But you guys keep on buying the mystery boxes because you think you're going to get, and you basically what you're doing is you're paying like $100 and some for an exclusive item. That's really all you're doing, okay? I don't know if people realize this, but like if you are a super fan of Jeffree Star and you're buying these mystery boxes, which I mean, I love mystery boxes. I love a mystery, okay? I do. I think the mystery when you open it is like, woo, I already got the 15 of those same Kleenex and pencils, you know? But like the thing for me is this, okay? Don't complain about it if you know what you're doing, okay? Like, if you've bought every product that Jeffree Star has put out, and you have bought every mystery box of Jeffree Star, what do you think is going to be the surprise in the mystery box? The mystery of opening it and seeing what products you got. That's the mystery of it, right? Seeing what you got that other people didn't or whatever, plus the exclusive item. The exclusive item is what pulls everybody in because they want that one exclusive item that you won't be able to get somewhere else, okay? This is not just to Jeffree Star. This is to anybody that does these mystery boxes or whatever, okay? Any company out there that does something like this. It's the mystery item that you're pulling everybody in. But the reality is the majority of these people that love Jeffree Star and they have bought all of his products, I mean, these people have literally rooms dedicated to Jeffree Star. They post the pictures of it in the thread, okay? Pictures upon pictures of makeup and more makeup and more makeup that you would ever be able to use. And they all say on there too, I couldn't possibly use your makeup because I don't want to ruin the beauty of what you have created, okay? It's a moneymaker. And so then they get duplicates of all of these products because they keep on buying these mystery boxes, which to Jeffree Star is just, for me, a huge cash grab because he knows the people that are going to buy it are the diehard fans. And they just fawn and go crazy because, oh my God, they got one exclusive item. And then they have like one little thing in there. They're like, oh my God, I don't know. I never had this before. But most of them have gotten everything that they've ever had in these mystery boxes before. So anyway, I'd like to see a mystery box of 12 or 13 items that have never been released. That would be a mystery box. You know, you really want to wow people and tell people you're the genius of the makeup industry? Put mystery boxes out. Put a Supreme, a Deluxe, a Mini, and whatever, and every box be completely different. So the Mini is different than the Deluxe, is different than the Supreme, okay? So what you get in the Mini is not just a smaller version of what you get in the Deluxe and the Supreme, but the Mini, you have to buy it individually because there are such different products in there. It's different than the Deluxe, it's different than the Supreme. So basically, if you want to get all these exclusive items, you got to buy all three boxes. And every box has something that has never been put out before. And I don't even really care at that point if one of them is cosmetic stickers like he did one year as the exclusive item, right? Because if you're getting it, you know, like, let's say a mirror, a brand new mirror that's never been put out before, and you're putting out the cosmetic stickers, and maybe, I don't know, a single shade of eyeshadow that has never been seen. So you come up with three different eyeshadows, and each box gets a different eyeshadow, you know? And then maybe like one old palette from the past, it's a mystery. But the majority of the products that are in there are all new. That would be a genius business idea, I think, you know? Can you imagine? People would go crazy. They'd be like, oh my God, I opened my box. I've never seen these products before. I would get on video and I would be like, Jeffree Star is super, super smart. Why doesn't he want to do that? Because this is him getting rid of a lot of old product that he's got sitting around. And maybe it's not expired yet, but maybe it's 6 months and he doesn't think it's going to, you know? But this is what I think happens. My aunt back in the day, okay, I used to go visit her in the summer. True story, I've talked about this on my vlog, right? And she had this part-time job where she went into grocery stores, okay? And when she would go into grocery stores, she would stock the pantyhose. And you pull the thing out, right? And she would say, put the new ones in back. That way, the oldest ones are the ones that will go first. Because if the ones in the back that are the newest and the freshest, people would buy those because they would think it's the newest and the freshest, but put the older ones in front because then they'll go and then the newer ones will come forward. Does that make sense? So yeah, it makes sense that, you know, okay. So if you do the same thing with what he's got in the warehouse, okay, which is here you have over here, let's say, I'm just gonna make this up, okay? Five of these thirsty palettes, okay? And they're like gonna expire in who knows how long, 6 months or something like that, right? And you've just made, let's say, five new thirsty palettes, and those are over here. You wanna move these thirsty palettes up to here. So what do you do with this? You throw them in mystery boxes. And you just do this every 3 to 6 months, and you put the products out that you've gotta push through and get rid of. It's genius. It's very smart. It's why he probably doesn't hold on to a lot of, you know, stuff. Except that he's not really selling out of the mystery boxes like he used to back in the day. So this person said, why did your company send me the same exact three shades, not to mention the most unwearable shade possible in my Supreme mystery box? Talk about disappointment. So people overall are not happy with Jeffree Star about these mystery boxes. Now, I mean, I will say, I shouldn't say overall. There are a lot of complaints about the mystery boxes. There were so many more that I found on there as well. But a lot of people are really happy with it. I will tell you what's interesting, though, is that everybody lays their things out and they just say, I'm so excited about my mystery box. I don't see anybody going super crazy about any one thing. But I will say this. I have not watched the reviews yet. I may watch a few of the reviews to see. But usually the Jeffree Star reviews of the mystery boxes are just like, oh my God, I love it so much. You know what I mean? But like, true story, like as a fan, if you're a Jeffree Star fan, are you telling me that you're not a little disappointed when you open a box? And let's just say that out of the 11 or 13 items or whatever, that 10 of them you've already gotten before. Are you not telling me you're a little disappointed? I would, if I don't care who, like I'm a super fan of, you know, if I had already purchased everything that they already had, like y'all know I love Jana DeLeon's Miss Fortune series, book series, right? I'm obsessed with her. I've read all 20 books that are out, okay? So if I got a Jana DeLeon Miss Fortune mystery box in the mail, well, I do. Actually, there's somebody out there that sends them to me anonymous and she signs them Miss Fortune. I love that so much. But you know, like if I got this mystery box and I paid $100 for it, okay? And I got like six of the 20 books, which I had already read. a t-shirt that I had already purchased, and let's say, I don't know, a map of the city that I already had, right? And then two of the products were things that maybe like sold out that quick and I couldn't get before. Like maybe some like novella that she had put out about the town, and she only did 100 of them and I couldn't get them, and that was one of them. I'd be real excited about that. Like that might even be worth it for me. And then an exclusive item, like I'm trying to think of something, I don't know. Like, you know, like a little character that looks like each of the characters in the book or something, you know? Like a, what are those called? I can't remember. What are those things called? Action figures, you know? Like, that would be really cool. Would it be worth to me $100, even with the 6 books that I already had? Probably it would, because I'd be like, oh my God, I got 2 of the things that I've never had before if I was, like, a super collector. So I understand the people that are really, you know, super fans getting excited about it. But if I opened that box, and it was a preview to her next book, it was a novella that I had never had, it was 3 action figures that I had never seen before, okay? It was some kind of like food item or something that took place in Sinful, Louisiana, where the books take place. If all 13 items were something that were kind of like roughly new that I had never seen before, oh my God. I would literally buy every mystery box ever put out again, and I don't care how horrible they were in the future. You know what I mean? And maybe that's it a little bit, is that maybe the mystery boxes from the past were better than the ones that they are now. But all I know is people aren't happy. People aren't happy. And apparently, like, this is not the first time I've heard people complain about Jeffree Star Cosmetics customer service. So, anyway, let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. Did you buy a Jeffree Star mystery box? If you did, were you happy with it? Let me know in the comment section. If you are elated and you absolutely love the mystery box, put that in the comment section and say, my little dog is right over here. You guys have to show you, okay? He's just, like, staring at me. Well, hello, Boo Radley. Do you want to come over and say hi to all the people? Oh, there's Tucker. Hi, Tucker. Say hi to everybody. Come here, Boo Radley. They're like, Dad, what's going on? He said, hello, everybody. Did you buy one of Jeffree Star's mystery boxes? He said, I did not. I did absolutely did not. Anyway, if you guys bought one and you loved it, put it in the comment section below and let me know what you loved about it. And if you were dissatisfied with it, let me know that as well. And if you're thinking, there's still some available. So if you're thinking about buying one, let me know that as well. So anyway, I love you guys and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.